Hello everyone. In today's session, we will continue our previous bank account entity extension. And there what we have changed is we have added a new field into bank account table, which is the table behind the bank account form or page. So there we have added a field called bank account title, and there was nothing logic or any code of X++ was written. And then we also, because the data source in bank account entity was bank account table, so automatically the field was also available here in the data source. Since we have changed the table already, we have added the field, and then also we included the same field in the fields node of the entity. So this was another change. And what else we have changed? We have also added a similar field to the staging table. So this is PKR bank account title, and this has, we have just copy pasted. So the all the properties were also the same. Extended data type, there was account name. And then we also checked in open in Excel experience, and the field was field value was completely written to the bank account table. So that was totally imported, and we just changed it. Actually, we have not inserted a new value. So now what we will do in this video, we'll use DMF, and in DMF we'll try to export the table first, and then we'll add a record, and then we'll import the record into the bank account table, so that it is also visible on the form level. One more change we have done in our previous video was on the form level, we have whatever the field what we have added, also we put into the form design so that it is visible for data entry. So that is another change which we have done there. So now I will just close Visual Studio because we have nothing to do here. Okay, and also make sure that batch service is running here, and also import export framework service is running before importing through DMF. So now we'll go, and this is also a demo of DMF, how we basically export an entity, and then we also import the entity after inserting the records. So we'll just click the export tile, and then we'll just put a group name, and group means a group of entities. You can enter multiple entities, you can sequence them in execution, means whatever the entity should execute first, and then second and third, in this order you can sort the entities. So I will just input the group name here, and this will be bank account, and then this will be a data project type of export and we'll also create another project for importing the same entity, and project category will keep it as a project. So then we'll go to the add entity command, and we can choose the bank account entity here. If this entity is not available for you, you can try to refresh the entities in DMF, because once you apply service update, so normally the entities are not automatically refreshed, so you need to refresh it. And then target data format is Excel, and okay, full push only, all fields, skip staging, yes. While we are exporting it, we don't need to be to the data to be available on a staging table. And the sample file is basically a selected column, the specific columns, so that will be used here, but we are not using it here. So just add here and close. So now the entity is available here, and you can also view the map where from the source to the target field are mapped in a visual form, and then you can also see here field-to-field mapping from the source field to the target field. So just close it. Okay, so now you have one row here, and you can see here execution unit is one, level in execution is one, then sequence is one. So if you insert any other entity, so that will have number two in execution. So I will just use export now command here, so that whatever the records are, they will be exported. They will be available here, and then you can download the file. So now I can also view the staging data, and since I have not selected the staging export, so it is not available. I will download the file, and this file will be downloaded in the format whatever I have defined, and that was Excel. So I can just open this Excel file. And you can see here there are four rows available, and these are various rows here. Okay, so what there are multiple, you can see there are various field values like bank account ID, bank account number, active from and active to, dates, and there are various other field values, address, description. So what I can do is I will just copy one row and I will paste it here, and then I will remove all the rows. Okay, so here I can input, for example, bank account ID. So this will be PKR and USMF test, and account number just to give something different, active from, active to, date, and whatever addresses we can just put here. I will keep them as it is, and then bank account, bank group ID is must. So I will just choose bank US, USA, and address valid to, and all the dates are there. Okay, so you can see here PKR bank account title field is also available. So I will just input my name here. What else? IBAN. IBAN is blank, so I will also keep it as blank. But if you have some values, you can also input. What else I can select? Account number. So there is also main account display value. So that's it. I have just changed it. I will save and then close it, and go to the DMF again, and just close the exported job, and also close this project. And now you can select the import title, and within import title just give the group as a good name. And data project operation type will be import, and project category is project. Now you just need to select add file. Source data format is Excel, although the other formats are also available, but it depends whatever file is available there. So you can select that. Okay, so then in the entity, I will select the same entity, bank account. And now here at the bottom, you can see upload data file. Here you can select the same file which you have changed. You have removed all the existing rows and you have incorporated a new row. So that I will just select here, bank account. Okay, so now select open. It will load the file information and it will inform you once it is done. Okay, so there are certain warnings which are showing in a non-editable field. So just skip it and read the message here. Bank account entity mapping has completed successfully. Just close it. You can see the view here. And from here you can see all the rows, all the field names are automatically mapped. So also you can see here PKR bank account title is automatically mapped as well to the bank account title. So this is source to staging mapping. Source is Excel and staging is whatever the field value field we have added in our Visual Studio project to the staging table. Also in this field to field mapping, you can also see bank account title from the source field, that is Excel, is mapped to the staging field. So that's it, just close it. And then what we can do is we can select import now, which will not run in batch. Import in batch will run in scheduled batch, and then re-import. If there are any changes to the file, then you need to just re-import and again upload the file. So what we can do is we'll just select import now, because we need to just manually run it. So now you can see a tick is coming up, means the job was successful. So and then we can also see our staging data. So here you can see staging to target is completed. Just review the field values. So account title is coming from Excel and it is also shown here. We'll just check in our bank account list page, and you can see here the I will just change it to the my view, where I can see the account title field. And you can see here all the values which we have filled in our Excel are just shown here, so including account title. So now what I can do is I will just again change this account title to some other value, okay, and then we'll see what happens once we are updating the record. So I will just go to the Excel file, and then in the account title I will change it to something like John David, okay, and just save it and close it. Now what I can do, I will again go to the DMF, just close this and also close this. Okay, now what we can do is we will select re-import here. Okay, within re-import you can see here upload file option is available. So just select upload file and go to browse, and then go to bank account file and upload it, and press OK. Okay, and then just select import. So now this time the batch job is scheduled in batch, and we'll just keep refreshing and make sure that your service batch management service is running. If it is one box, otherwise definitely on production it must be running. Okay, I will just keep refreshing, and now you can see here the tick is available, means the job has executed successfully. So we can check view execution log. So whatever has happened, and it is saying 0 records created and 1 record updated. Okay, so it means it has automatically taken care for the update. And then we can also see our view staging data. And here we can see account title is John David. And then we'll just refresh here, and you can see account title is automatically updated to John David. So that is it, guys. And we have just demoed the same entity, an existing entity called bank account. Then we have changed, basically we have added a field to bank account table, and then the same field we have also included in the corresponding entity, which is bank account entity. And also we checked and verified the insertion of the records and updation of the records. So through open in Excel experience, as well as we have also checked it in DMF, and it is working. So in this way you can change your out of the box entities, whatever number of fields you need to add, you just need to add it to the primary tables or whatever the tables are behind certain, you know, form like bank account table. There can be foreign key tables as well. So then definitely those fields need to be added to the ent- corresponding entities in the way I have done it, and again to the staging tables, and then through DMF or open in Excel experience you can basically import or export the data or update the data. So that's it. Thank you very much, and please comment, and if you need anything else just let me know. Thank you, take care, bye bye.